So other nutrients in food, I'm just going to touch on some of these things: magnesium, sodium or salty foods, meat and high protein foods, caffeine again, and soft drinks. So magnesium, normal levels really does help protect bone. Higher intakes of magnesium have been related to higher bone density. Magnesium is really available in a lot of good hearty foods that you see here at the bottom of this slide. I do know a lot of people that take supplemental magnesium, and whether it's for bone health, but it also helps a lot of times with regularity. So when I see people taking magnesium supplementation, I'm always a little bit skeptical why, you know, and a lot of times it really does help with GI regularity. But again, this is something that you can pretty easily get from food, so there's not necessarily a reason to supplement magnesium. Sodium in salty foods, we as Americans probably consume twice as much sodium or salt as we need. And so really you got to be careful, because high salt intake can really cause your body to lose calcium, leading to bone loss. So I would try to limit it. Most people think, well, I don't use a salt shaker, I'm really saving so much salt. And that's really the minimum of how people get sodium in their diet. Processed food, canned foods, we really are kind of a on the go, like everything easy, like everything prepared for us. So if you are not preparing something, seasoning it yourself, there is usually built in a bunch of sodium in there. So meat and high protein foods, we are also, over the past probably 10 years, become super protein obsessed, and protein, 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 everyone's doing some form of a high protein diet. So too much protein really can be harmful. Again, as Americans, we are pretty much consuming on a regular basis twice as much protein as we need. Even with kids, I see parents saying, oh no, he doesn't eat enough protein. Like this, it is definitely untrue. So I mean, unless there is some sort of diet restriction, issue with digestion, religious preference or whatever, it's just really not the case. You just want to be careful of how much you're consuming. Remember that dairy does contain protein. It is not one of the highest tier of protein containing foods, but it does have it, but it also has calcium in there. So you're at least getting a little bit of calcium from the dairy foods. Caffeine, you really want to be careful with caffeine intake. Most people, the recommendation is 2 to 3 servings. And by servings, I mean probably if you're having coffee or tea, about a normal size cup, which would be 8 ounces. And for Starbucks goers, it would be a tall. And for Dunkin' Donuts people, it would be like whatever a small is. That would be 1 serving. So if you're having ventis or large coffees every day and having multiples, and in the presence of inadequate bone nutrients, meaning calcium and vitamin D, you are very likely leading to or kind of helping your body along with bone loss. Soft drinks. Colas, really, I think, and this is more because of the phosphorus, colas, meaning brown colas, not the lighter colors, or like ginger ale, Sprite, 7-Up, all of those things don't have phosphorus in them naturally, but you really just want to be careful. Carbonation in itself is not harmful to bone. It is the phosphorus in the colas. But again, caffeine, I've now seen caffeine added to sodas that were never caffeine containing. So a lot of the orange sodas, grape sodas now have caffeine added. And so you just really want to know what you're consuming, how much you're consuming of these things. And really more likely, you know, a lot of the soft drinks is sort of over the past few decades. I feel like the people in your 20s and 30s now really didn't grow up necessarily drinking milk every day. And so it also, you know, there were more energy drinks, soft drinks, you're sort of that generation. And so that kind of just, it was replacing the calcium-rich drinks.